Hi, welcome to Sassy Mess Kitchen again. Tonight we're having friends over for an outside barbecue, social distancing, of course, but we want to make food ahead of time so that I'm not going to be cooking while our friends are here. So we decided to make chicken shish kebabs. Thank you to Sarah, who taught us this recipe. But we're going to make our own sauce, and it's going to involve teriyaki. And again, this is just making it up. I'm just going to glug it in, because it's going to be kind of a teriyaki Asian inspired fun. Here's some soy sauce. Soy sauce. And we have this Chinese sweet and sour sauce that I bought at Viet Ho.
Show me.
It's from the Viet Ho store. It's real good. It's kind of like, sweet. It's sweet. And then we're gonna add some rice vinegar, because we all know that the vinegar helps with tenderizing.
Show your rice vinegar.
Yes. This brings salad to life and sauce. Glug, glug, glug. And now you're gonna think this is very odd, but I always like some mustard to bring some tang. Squirt it in there. And we're gonna add this amazing wipeout sauce. We bought it, I think in Florida, and it's got this, it's like a pineapple hemp hot sauce. So it just adds a little sweetness and heat to the fruit. So any kind of a fruity hot sauce is amazing.
Glug, glug, glug.
And however much you want, it's all up to you. Do you like it really hot, not hot, medium hot? And we gotta have our heat with our cock sauce. Sriracha.
AKA Sriracha.
Then I'm gonna take my little whisker friend. Hello, my whisker friend. I'm going to mix it. And you got to mix it a lot to get the mustard combined. Otherwise, it'll be lumpy. And then you're going to need to taste it and see if you like the flavor of it. Oh, wait, we forgot ginger powder. Ginger powder. Okay.
Okay.
Now you're going to mix it.
Shake it up, chef.
Shake it.
Let me get that shot. Oops, stepped on the cat.
Smells pretty good. So then you're going to cut up vegetables, chicken, and you're going to marinate it. So I'll show you that in a minute.
Thank you.
All right, so our sauce is amazing and mixed and happy. So now it's time to cut the chicken. Now, would you use this knife to cut the chicken?
No.
Would you use this knife to cut the chicken?
No.
Or this knife to cut the chicken?
Yes.
This is the fillet knife. This is the butcher knife. You could use it if you're cutting chicken bones.
Do you recall that video, friends?
And this
that
is bread
was funny.
Knife. Bread knife. Okay.
Serrated, not for cutting chicken.
Good answer.
Thank you.
Now we have to trim the chicken again, because this is the untrimmed chicken, because it's what we're affording right now. COVID can't have good chicken.
Yes.
You know, it's actually easy just to trim it. I'd rather trim it myself then spend more and have somebody else trim it. But see, this one was trimmed. Interesting. So we're gonna cut it into nice size shapes to put on a skewer. So we're gonna cut them into pretty equal size. That's a really big, don't do that. That one, yeah. You want them pretty equal so they cook at a very similar time. But there's some more yuck. Go away, yuck. Bleh. Don't like that. All right, chicken for kebabs. Chicken. And what do we do after we're done cutting the chicken?
Wash our hands.
And I use this green cutting board only for chicken mainly.
Chicken.
Never put vegetables or fruit on it. And because we are having company, I'm actually doing two chicken breasts.
Woohoo, company.
So we're not gonna be hungry.
Woohoo, friends.
And you never wanna cut your fingers, and you don't wanna put your finger on the knife like that.
Or Amberell will make it red.
She'll put a red mark on it, and that means you're bad.
How come you can't have your finger up there?
I guess it's dangerous.
That makes sense.
I guess, I don't know, because I wouldn't cut myself if I did that. I feel if I put my finger here, I'd cut it. Right?
It's not a proper technique, I guess.
No, maybe it just doesn't.
Just like playing mallets. Not proper technique. Do not put your finger on the mallet, or Ms. Dolan chops it off and puts it in her finger jar and eats it for lunch later.
That's weird.
Just kidding, I don't do that.
All right. Cubed. Similar size.
That was so fast.
I know.
Whoop. That was really close. Oh, sorry.
I'm going to put it in my bag. Then I'm going to add the marinade. And I'm going to let it sit for a bit. My chicken is marinating, and now it's time to cut the vegetables that will go on our kebabs. Peppers. Red peppers. I don't like green peppers, so I'm not adding them, but a lot of people like them. I love red onions, so definitely red onions. And then this is really, really weird, but these whole new potatoes actually go really, really good on a kebab. I don't eat anything from a can, but these are good with kebabs. So we're gonna cut them into pieces that are whatever size you like for your kebab. Kebab, not a kerbob. Silly me. All the vegetables are cut. We've got all of this good stuff. I forgot to mention I wanted zucchini on my shish kebabs as well. So I'm going to marinate the vegetables with the chicken in my amazing sauce that we made. I'm not going to marinate the potatoes just yet. I'll put those in the marinade probably within the last 15 minutes of marinating because they kind of fall apart. So you're just going to dump them in here. The only skewers I have are these wooden sticks. And because we're going to grill it, you need to soak the wooden sticks in water so they don't catch on fire, because shish kebabs should not burn. That would be so bad. So we're gonna just mix it and wait. Now it is time to add the potatoes. So I've taken out all our marinated vegetables and chicken. Then we've got the potatoes out. You see the potatoes? They're right there. And then I'm gonna cut them into bite-sized pieces. I'm gonna add them to this. And then we're gonna let it marinate for about 5 minutes. And then I'm gonna stab all the vegetables and the chicken with our skewers. That's really fun, so stay tuned for that. Strange looking canned potatoes. It's the strangest thing I've ever eaten out of a can, but it's so good. All right, I'm getting ready to skewer all of this good stuff together and make some kebabs. But in the meantime, we're having a yummy drink made. Beverage chef, what are you making for us today?
So today, for a special drink, we love red wine, but it's really hot. So I added ice and then half black box, because that's our fave.
Black box!
And then half soda water.
Yeah, soda.
And then I'm going to squeeze fresh lemon and orange juice into it. And I learned that from Amy Schumer Learns to Cook. And it's supposed to have vermouth, but I don't know what that is, so we're not going to add it.
And please tell me, where did you get that amazing dress?
Cindy Buck.
It's an original.
It's a Cindy Buck original. Sweetwater.
Love it.
Skewering 101. I'm gonna start with a pepper. Now you can do any order you want. I'm just gonna show you one because you'll get the idea. And you don't wanna watch me do all these because it's kind of boring. Don't stab your finger. I did that and got a splinter last time. It hurt bad. Zucchini. Then I'm gonna choose some amazing onion, because onion is gonna make you live longer. And then chicken, gobble gobble, waka waka. And then whatever you want. I think I'll do a red pepper. Oh wait, oh, I forgot potatoes. There's a little potato. The weird potatoes, but I'm okay with it now.
Mm. This is not an orange.
What is it?
It's a caracara.
I like caracaras.
It's like a grapefruit.
Grapefruit. We're gonna have some caracara in our wine today. We'll let you know.
I'm totally gonna mess up my sangria, guys. But caracara. You know what?
You know it's gonna be better.
They're gorgeous.
All right, so I'm gonna add, I think, an onion on the top. So here I did a couple chickens, a couple peppers, a couple onions, and then we're gonna do it again like 12 times. It's gonna be fun. A Look at all those skewers. We made so many. And we kind of started with a hard thing on the bottom, like a pepper. And then you want to make sure there's a lot of space in between your chicken and the whatever's next to, so it'll cook evenly. And now we're going to salt and pepper it, lightly salt it because we did marinate it in soy sauce, but pepper. And then you just pop it on the grill and it's going to be so tasty. Look at our cactus. Cute. Getting ready for our dinner. Looks like it might rain, but whatever. It's life. It always rains on your parade. All right, so we're gonna stick it on the grill. I'm gonna have it on medium temperature. We're gonna plop them all on. All right, here they are. Happy little skewers. I dumped any extra juice I had on top of them. And I'm gonna close the grill, and then I'll just keep an eye on them and keep.
All right, I've taken the kebabs off the grill. Everything's happily cooked and we're gonna have a nice, yummy dinner. Fortunately, it's gonna rain, so we're gonna socially distance inside.
All right, it's all done. We gotta take the food off the skewers.
Like, but wait.
What?
Welcome, special guest, Sharon and Luann. Hey. Our first dinner guest since the quarantine. Woohoo!
Yes.
All right.
Okay. So we're gonna try a bite of our food. We got potato, which is really weird, like I said, from the can. Pepper, are you doing pepper?
Zucchini.
Nice. I'm going to do a little pepper bite. You can do some chicken. All right. Cheers up.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Is it dank or stink?
Wow. Oh, no, you
go for
it. Okay.
That's going dank.
It was really good, yeah.
You liked it?
Delicioso. Delicioso.
How good was it?
Delicioso.
I like that.
Delicioso.